Number bonds part 1 with teacher Farah.
So the big idea that you need to know about number bonds is that when we put two parts together, we make up a whole. So far so good. Now that we've learned what a number bond is, let's look at an example to help us understand how it works. Alright? So say we have 3 pieces of candies and 7 pieces of candies. These 3 pieces of candies that we have is part of everything that we have, correct? So let's write the number 3 in one of these parts. Then what about the other 7 pieces of candies? The other 7 pieces of candies are also a part of everything that we have. And can you guess what we are going to do? If you said write the number 7 in this other part here, you're totally right. Okay, when we put these two parts together, 3 candies and 7 candies, how many candies do you think we have all together? Let's count, alright? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 candies in all. And they look really delicious. So since 10 candies are all that we have, we are going to write the number 10 into the circle on the top. And this represents the whole, remember? Looks like our number bond is complete. And by looking at this, what can you tell? Are you able to see that 3 and 7 make 10? This time round, we have 4 shiny gold coins and 5 shiny gold coins. So do we call each of them a part or a whole? If you said each of them is a part, great job at paying attention. Since we know that number 4 is a part, and the number 5 forms another part, we put the numbers in the circles that represent the parts. So far so good. Then what should we do to complete the number bond? Do you know what's the missing whole? Let's count how many shiny gold coins we have when we put the coins together. Okay? Looks like we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 gold coins. Well, someone's getting rich. Now that we have the number 9, do you know where it goes? It goes into the circle on the top. So now we know that when we have a part of 4 and a part of 5, we'll end up having a total of 9. Understand so far?